Hi everybody and welcome to another Laravel tutorial. In today's video I'm going to be going through how to use this new Laravel Websockets package but on Laravel Forge using SSL. I was trying for a while to get it working and it's been a bit of trial and error, and I've not seen any documentation anywhere on how to set it up on Forge using Let's Encrypt. So I thought I'd make a quick video just so that if anybody else is using Forge to deploy this new Laravel Websockets package, it makes it a bit easier for them. So the first thing that I'm going to show you that I've done is if you go into config and then broadcasting.php, I've separated some of these values out into environment variables. What that'll help do is let you have a local version and a production version, so you can have it without HTTPS on your local machine or with on your production. So if you look at yours, it's probably a bit different to this, but what all I've done is change these so that I can put different environments in different places. So this scheme here was usually just set to HTTP, but now when it's on Forge I can change this to HTTPS. So if I look in my .env file, if you look in my .env file, I've got the pusher scheme as HTTPS. Few of these, I think that you don't have to actually have these set as real pusher values, but I've not tried with or without yet, so I'm not sure about that. Also, I've changed this broadcast driver to pusher, which I'm guessing you will have already done if you've set this up locally. And then because Forge comes with Redis pre-installed, I've changed the queue to Redis as well, which should make things quicker on the front end. You will have to set this value as your site as well, so whatever your URL is, you'll have to set that, which will probably be HTTPS if you're using Let's Encrypt. So as well as that, there's in the Websockets config, which comes with the package, to get that, let me just have a quick look. Yeah, so to generate that, you just run this command once it's installed. And then that will give you this websockets.php in the config folder. And I've just used those same environment variables again on each one. So it's quite good because you only have to edit it in one place, which is the .env file. I think this should be false, actually, unless you're debugging. In my project that I'm working on this, I want client messages enabled, which that's set to false by default. So for things like the typing notifications and things like that, you want that set to true. Also, further down in the websockets.php config, you'll see this SSL section, which you need to fill out. So what I've done is added some more environment variables. And these two are your certificate and private key file for your SSL. So what you want to do, what I've done is use the Let's Encrypt, which you can do easily through Forge. And what I've done is put them in the .env file. So this is where you expect to see them if you're using Forge and Let's Encrypt. If you CD into this SSL folder here, and then you'll see your domain, then it'll be in another folder with a number, and then you'll see the two files. So you need to change this to whatever yours is. As well as that, I saw somewhere else that this should be used. I've not tried it without that yet, so maybe try it with it and then take it out and see if it still works. But it could be required, I'm not sure about that one. And then in the bootstrap.js, where you set up your Echo, Laravel Echo, you want to just this is what you get by default. So you want to put encrypted to true for HTTPS, and then it uses WSS instead of WS when you're using a secure connection. So I added this WSS port as 6001. I think the rest of it's pretty much the same, but if you copy this, then it should work, hopefully. So then, when you get to Forge, I've just set up a brand new server here just to explain how to do it. So what you want to do is, you want to run this command, but even if the server restarts, you want it to automatically run that again. So what you need to do is go on this daemons, and you want to run that there, but you can't just paste this in because it's got to have the path and everything. So I found a good way of getting the path is just to go to scheduler. If you copy, basically this is going to be our URL, so it'd be something like that. So if you copy this part of it, and then go back to the daemons, paste that in, space, and then copy this third bit, and then paste that there. And that should, basically, it probably won't work now because I've not got a site set up, but then if you just press start, that'll make sure that command is running. And then another thing that you've got to do is open the port, because it runs on 6001 for the WebSockets. So if you do just like that, I've left this blank and it seemed to work, so add that rule, and then that should allow the WebSockets to communicate on that port, which is required. And then one more thing that you got to do on, I'm hosting mine on DigitalOcean, so if you've got to set up, basically all you've got to do is add this custom TCP rule in the firewall, which you can get to by going to networking and then firewall at the top. And all you do is just create a new rule, custom TCP, and then just put, it won't let me add it because I've already got it there, but you need to add that so that it allows connections on that port on the actual firewall as well. And then hopefully that should be it. It seemed to work for me that way anyway. But if anyone's got any questions, feel free to ask in the comments and I'll try and answer them. Hopefully this helped you. If it did, please like and subscribe, and I'll try and do some more videos around this area if that's what people want. If you've got any more ideas for tutorials that I can do in the future, just let me know in the comments and I'll try and do them. Cheers. Thanks a lot.